So after 7 days of retreat, the basic clarity is easily recognized, easily found, easily accessed. Let's relax the body thoroughly, including relaxing eyes, brain, scalp, jaws, mouth. Let intentions melt. Let the long neck muscles relax, and the muscles at the base of the skull in the back, where there's the center, you know, there's the edge of the skull in the back of the head, where the, you know, where it feels soft. So let that area relax. That's the seat of the subconscious mind. One of the trigger points of subconscious mind. Very important is the fact that our basic nature is joyful. There's joy in it. Subtle blissfulness. Feel that. Recognize that aspect of the basic nature. That it feels pleasant, blissful, joyful, festive, I think that's the word, festive. Happy. Happy and easy. In different Mahasiddhas, different masters, according to their personalities, different aspects of the basic nature are embodied and exemplified and expressed. To me personally, this joyful, happy, joyous, and in that sense even mischievous, has always spoken to me, has always attracted me. there is this special magnetism to this, it feels silly to say aspect of nature of mind, but it is an aspect. But really, we are talking about the qualities that our basic nature has. Because Buddhism focuses on removing ignorance first, is why the aspect of selflessness, you know, selfless knowing, gets emphasized a lot. Because we need to remove ignorance through wisdom. And wisdom means transparency, diamond-likeness. And there's no room, you know, like I have workshopped many times, you know, if you start go too far with joyfulness, bliss, then you might end up come to a dead end. But nevertheless, empty clarity and soft bliss are aspects of the same nature of mind, our true being. And this joyous, loving, soft aspect of ours, it has special magnetism, special feel. It is like it is love, actually. This subtle, completely peaceful and grounded love. It's not love as a high, as a gross love. It's not like a teenager's first love type high, but subtle. And as you can feel in your body, it magnetizes the body in a certain way. In a very pleasant way, in a very natural way. Feels very good. So notice, recognize this joyful, blissful love that is sober and grounded in your whole being, in your body, in your energy, in your aura. We are meditating to attain Mahasiddhahood for the sake of all beings. yesterday briefly in the evening. I was talking with Lama Karl about this drunken bliss that sometimes meditators have, or people who are actually intoxicated on alcohol, they have that same bliss. But here the bliss is grounded and stays grounded. There is basic peacefulness and basic clarity at the same time with the bliss. This is subtlest kind of bliss. That the kind of bliss that is natural and spontaneous. Sahaja Nanda. Sahaja Nanda. This is the bliss of the Buddhas and Mahasiddhas. This is the bliss body, joyfulness body, or enjoyment body of the Buddhas. Interestingly, because there is magnetism, like in the emptiness body, Dharmakaya, there is no magnetism. It's just clarity. Just the zero dimensional space marked by clarity. But when we switch bodies, from emptiness body to enjoyment body, Sambhogakaya, things change. There is magnetism, there is, you could say that integration between bodies starts happening. It also very much touches and is felt in the physical body. You can ask yourself, does this joyfulness feel safe? Does it feel safe? Can it be trusted? Ask this question to yourself. When we realize that something can be, something is safe and trusted, then we can really relax. Let our guard down. Then we can let go. And this is very important. So now we are recognizing this enjoyment body, mostly in the area of our physical body. Keep it, but at the same time, can you sense that same joyous quality actually everywhere and in everything around you? Can you sense it, recognize it in life around you? Not only that, all phenomena, all things are empty, but all things, all phenomena is joyous. This is a very special point that actually goes beyond emptiness teachings. This is light body practice. as minutes and moments go by, the bliss and clarity become more and more normal, becomes integrated. Michael, you're blissing out because your head is not still. So the recognition doesn't happen in your head when you're going like this all the time. So that's why keep your body still so that the recognition can happen in your whole body. That's my point. Take several deep breaths. Filling not only the lungs, but the whole body. With love. And then stretch. Do whatever stretches you feel like. And after you've stretched for a moment, lie down for 15-20 minutes.